The views and opinions expressed on this program are not necessarily those of this station, JVC Broadcasting Management, or its sponsors.
Hi, I'm Attorney Phil Jusino, and my law firm is Philip J. Jusino & Associates PC, located in Lake Grove, New York. After graduating from Fordham Law School in 1989, I immediately began representing the interests of Long Islanders, first as a Suffolk County Assistant District Attorney, then in the private sector. I also served as a law guardian for 5 years. I started my own law firm, and on a daily basis, I passionately fight for my clients, whether it be a divorce, a family court matter, a criminal matter, or involving personal injury. I am available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Once again, I am Attorney Phil Jusino, and my law firm is Philip J. Jusino & Associates PC, located at 2780 Middle Country Road, Lake Grove, New York, 11755, Suite 208. Call me for a prompt response, 631-588-3155. That's 631-588-3155. Your rights are our fight. I'm Attorney Phil Jusino, and you are listening to Phil Jusino Drive at 5 here on 103.9 FM LI News Radio. You can listen to the show every Monday evening from 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. as you drive home. Tonight, I have in the studio David Zere, a friend of mine. We go way back, host of Breaking Point on Real America's Voice News. Good evening, Dave.
Hey, how are you, Phil? It's great to be back with you again.
Good, good. We've done a couple of shows together in the past. It's been a while, but it's great to have you in, especially so close to this election. 7 days and a wake up, and it's going to be monumental.
Yeah, it's going to be. I think Trump wins legally all day long. I'm just scared of what's going on. There's a lot of fraud going on, and there's a lot of lawsuits right now. So
they each have their team of attorneys, especially the Democrats. They have their attorneys ready. What's going to be interesting is this is the first time New York has had early voting. Now, mail-in ballots are pretty new. We haven't had them for very long. We've had absentee ballots. And so many times I talk to people and they get confused. What's an absentee? What's a mail-in? The concern is the mail-in ballots. I have some concerns, especially not just New York. When they mail them out, we all get mail from people that lived in our house maybe 20 years ago. Or I told the story. My father-in-law stayed with me from time to time, never lived with me. The last time Three Village had an election for the school board, right, I got a ballot for my father-in-law. He never lived there. Now, that wasn't a presidential, but still, it's an election that I could have just wrote his name in, picked the three members of the board, and sent it in.
So places like Long Island, we don't have a lot of voter fraud. But in like Philadelphia, New York City, and Chicago, you know, it's a mess. I think that early voting should be illegal. Look what's going on with the incredible Hunter Biden videotapes going on. And there's going to be bombshell dropped tomorrow. There's going to be bombshells dropped all week. And people have been voting for like a month.
And Minnesota, September.
Yeah, and one third of the vote is in. I think it's completely wrong. I think all of those early voting ballots should be rescinded and people should take another stab at it because there is no way that Biden's not compromised from a national security perspective. And, you know, he can be held hostage by the Chinese for foreign policy if he's president because they've got so much dirt on Hunter and him.
What's interesting is I don't know if you saw a post I did on Facebook. Do you know that if you voted by mail-in ballot or absentee ballot, you can legally change your vote? Did you know that?
Yes.
All you have to do is show up on November 3rd or early voting. But if you early vote, you're stuck with it. If you vote by machine, that's your vote. People don't know that.
No, and you know, Trump usually gets better during the debates. And his last debate, he cleaned Biden's clock, and you know, people were already voting in parts of the country. In Las Vegas, they're not going to double check now on the computer system to see if the ballots were correct when they went through the electronic voting machines. And the naked ballots went out in Pennsylvania. The Republicans sued. The state Supreme Court ruled a couple of weeks ago that the naked ballots being mailed out by the Democrats are illegal because it shreds the protection of secrecy with a secrecy ballot envelope inside of the main ballot. And, you know, if it gets to the Board of Elections, if there's no secrecy envelope in there, you could tell what party the person's registered with, and they could just throw the ballot in the garbage. So, you know, I think, but I think there's momentum. You know, I'm in the White House press pool with Real America's Voice News. I travel all over the country. I've been to 20 states in the last 10 months, a year. And what's not being told is that Middle America, Pennsylvania, Ohio, even New Hampshire, there's no way that Trump is down in the polls, especially in Pennsylvania and Ohio and like states like Michigan.
Right. I don't
just
really,
not true.
I don't trust the polls. You heard Trafalgar. Yes. came out totally different. He's saying the polls are wrong.
Yes.
He has a different system. Also, a Northcott from Stony Brook.
And Rasmussen today kind of changing their tune. Right. But I interview people at the Trump rallies, and about 25% of the people that I interview on the ground are Democrats or independents.
Really?
Half of them are women, at least. They love Trump. And his biggest gains now are with white suburban moms who are college educated.
And he needs that because that's what the polls keep telling us he doesn't have.
Yeah. So in Ohio, you know, Trump bought tank building back. There's high-grade premium steel in Toledo, which has suffered. It used to be the glass center for America, but their economy's been in the tank. Trump, they say it's three times better than when Trump took office, Toledo. In Pennsylvania, the boilermakers, the steelworkers, the coal miners, the fracking people, the automakers, everybody, they're all coming out for Trump. And the boilermakers, which are traditionally, you know, blue dog Democrats, are voting for Trump.
Right. Why do you think, and you talk to people, do you speak to a lot of independents? Because I always say independents decide presidential elections.
I do, especially in New Hampshire. I've been there four times in the last year covering Trump rallies. And about 30% of the people there in New Hampshire are independents or Democrats. And they're pretty educated voters up there. And, you know, they take pride in being an independent. But I have not met a business owner yet in New Hampshire. I've been there many, many times. I have not met a business owner in Mississippi, Kentucky, Pennsylvania, Ohio, wherever I've been that is a Biden supporter. And I haven't seen one Biden sign anywhere in the country except in Florida.
There were two on my block. But let me ask you a question.
Yeah, Long Island has them.
James Carville astutely said, it's the economy, stupid.
Yes.
Then you like to hear also some on the left say, well, it's COVID-19. I personally think it's still going to be, the bottom line, the economy.
Well, the unemployment rate in the blue states is 11 and 12% on average. It's 5 to 6% in the red states. And they've been open since May and June. And all these red states and southern states have one half to one-tenth of the death rates per capita of, say, New York, New Jersey, and Massachusetts. So the lockdowns were a huge mistake. And we're going to lose many, many millions of years of human life due to the lockdowns, from mental stress, from suicides, opioid deaths, up 30,000 this year. Suicides, they say maybe 75,000. Suicide hotlines up 65%. Breast cancer, 60% of women aren't getting treatment. 40% of men aren't getting heart treatment. You know, dental problems, diabetes, strokes, all this stuff. And then all the plaque building up in the arteries of these business owners who are carrying the lockdowns on their back, blowing through their life savings, and everyone else is sitting at home collecting a check. Say, stay home, stay home, stay home. So the virus has a big numbers now, but the death rates have not gone up. Today, there's only 7 deaths per state in the United States. Yesterday, there were 5. You know, and it's so convenient. All of a sudden, we're at 100,000 cases a day a week before the election, and the stock market tumbles at 800 points today. So, you know, they're trying to get the fix in. But GDP's coming in the third quarter at 34%. And it's the biggest on record ever. Right. And the economy is back. But the blue states, I think, have cost this economy about 20% of its value with their lockdowns.
The overall unemployment is about 7 or thereabouts. Overall, that's amazing considering it went up to like, what, 14, 15% when we got hit hard?
Yes.
My stock portfolio lost like 50%. It raged back. I was buying during that time. So we had to have faith in the economy. And I think Biden would like this country to believe that Trump is a failure. And I don't know how he comes to that conclusion.
Well, it's ridiculous because under Obama, you know, he inherited a recession, but the GDP only grew at 1 and 2% per year, and he never had the feds raise interest rates on him for 7 and a quarter years of his presidency. Trump achieved 3% GDP, even with the feds working against him and raising rates, which they never should have done because we would have hit 4% GDP easy. Right.
And the experts said it wouldn't happen.
Yeah, and I'm in business and construction and development on Long Island, and you know every single person who's in the business knows the truth. And the truth is that the economy took off like a rocket ship when Trump came into office. Just between the stock market numbers and the development and everything that's going on and consumer confidence, at March it was at an all-time high. So I think we'll be back. It'll probably be slower than we think because Michigan, you know, Minnesota, California, New York, Manhattan is a ghost town. It smells like human waste and marijuana everywhere in the city. It's disgusting. 75% ridership down on the subway, comedy clubs, theaters, restaurants. 90% of restaurants in August could not pay rent in August. It's a disaster. It's an unmitigated disaster, and it's going to take many years to come back.
They got to get a Republican as mayor of New York City, like when they had Giuliani. Even Bloomberg kept it going.
Bloomberg did, but you know it started to go down under Bloomberg too. I noticed a lot more homeless in the last 2-3 years of his mayorship. You know, Giuliani had all the way up to 116th Street on the east side. You could eat off the floor. And I noticed that growing backwards under Bloomberg. And I noticed more homeless on the street. And Bloomberg definitely messed up the traffic patterns, but he did a pretty good job in the economy overall. I was with Giuliani last week, and I interviewed him in December, also before COVID. He was crying during my interview because I was part of this anchor revitalization program in New York City where they gave people home ownership possibilities and they gave federal loan guarantees to builders to take risks in 116th and Lenox, Malcolm X Corridor, Harlem, Coney Island, Mermaid Avenue, Fulton Avenue, Broadway Corridor. And these builders went out and took these risks because of Giuliani. None of that is going on now. And Giuliani was so upset. And I just had Curtis Sliwa on my show the other day, and I was talking to him last week as well. You know,
he's running for mayor.
He hates Trump. They have like a feud.
Oh, really?
But he's really in touch with the people. And if anybody knows how to handle the street problems, it's Curtis. And he thinks that the cops should not be dealing with mental health issues. You know, they didn't sign up for that. We need more patrolling. Cops are not patrolling in the city. They're standing down. They're calling in sick. They're retiring. Why would they want to do it? A 20-year-old girl was thrown on the subway tracks the other day. A 22-year-old tourist was shot in the chest in Bushwick the other day. My daughter lives in Chelsea. There's homeless encampments everywhere. I'm worried she's going to get sucked down a sewer drain. I'm never going to see her again. You know, it's terrible. My son lives in the Upper West Side. They destroyed it, you know, by putting all these homeless shelters in hotels without mental health support, without, you know, drug intervention. And they just throw it. So the homeless problem is sad in New York City, and they're just getting ignored. So the Democrats aren't really helping anybody or helping anything.
Now, the Hunter Biden story, do you think that has any legs? I know we have only about 8 days until the election. The mainstream media, CNN, MSNBC, they're not reporting on it. That's irresponsible.
I think the proof is in the pudding that Hunter had a deal with his father. He traveled to like 20 countries on Air Force Two, to Kazakhstan, all these countries. James Biden had a meeting in the White House with Joe Biden,
and
ten days later, he got a 100,000 house contract to build houses in Iraq. They got a big solar deal in Jamaica and Costa Rica. There's definitely pay to play, and Biden, it was James Biden, isn't a builder. He just got this, you know, magically got all this work. Hunter Biden stayed on the board of Burisma after the British government froze $23 million because they knew money was being laundered. And Theresa Hines, Kerry's son, his partner, even stepped down from Burisma. Hunter Biden stayed on the board. He's an unsavory individual, and they are so knee-deep in this. It's so incredible what has gone on. We haven't even scratched the surface. And I think the saddest part is the FBI's had the laptop for a year.
That was my question. What is the FBI doing?
They're trying to get Trump out of office. You know, the leadership in the FBI. Christopher Wray, there's no doubt in my mind.
Well, he's gone if
that
Trump
he's an anti-Trumper. You know, and we know the extensive corruption. And what's a joke is Peter Strzok got a job teaching at Georgetown.
I heard about
that. So pathetic. This guy was a vile individual who tried to lead a coup to take out the president of the United States. And with Bruce Orr and Nellie Orr, we're very disappointed. You know, Greg Jarrett warned that Bill Barr may not be the right pick for attorney general. And everybody said he was crazy. But look what happened. We have no indictments with Durham. And there's no doubt that McCabe broke the law. There's no doubt that this was all a setup. Papadopoulos was set up in Europe. We know that the whole Russiagate was launched due to Hillary Clinton's condoning of a piece of advice from a foreign policy consultant going back to early as April of 2016. It's a fact. It's out there. So, but I think the Hunter Biden thing, just the tapes the other day, I watched all the videos that came out from the Chi-Com, you know, they released it. Just the fact that they have pictures of him smoking crack with hookers, and now they say there's pictures of underage girls, and then maybe even posing with his
niece.
Now, if
the FBI knew about that and didn't do anything, that is criminal.
It's inexplicable. You know, I know the FBI agents on the ground are great guys in the JTTF. I lost my best friend in 9/11, you know, when I was a teenager. And, you know, we support all of that. But I think up to 40,000 people received, you know, the wiretapping and the FISA warrants. And how many of those people were railroaded with corrupt FBI practices? If they did it to Trump, and that James Comey knowingly signed off on four of them, knowing there was false information in there, how do we know that tens of thousands of other Americans weren't railroaded?
Yeah, but there are no consequences. There never seems to be consequences.
Democrats never go to jail.
Right, well, look at Hillary.
Yeah, I mean, you know, so listen, you know, you could say Hillary's corrupt and Whitewater and all the stuff, and we know all the incredible stories that have taken place. But even if you can't directly link to her, and people in her administration did get in trouble, like Craig Livingston and Webb Hubble and, you know, these guys, some went to jail. But the extent of the corruption that went on under the Clintons, and look at Bill Clinton. He committed 11 felonies in the office: of perjury, suborning perjury, abuse of power, obstruction.
Man, he
of
lost
justice.
His license. That's about it.
Yeah, and he was like the only president to be disbarred for 5 years. Had to pay a $90,000 fine for committing perjury in court, something to that
slap
extent
on the wrist.
By Judge Susan Weber Wright. You know, and look, and nothing happened to Bill Clinton. But, you know, that was the Senate Republicans that sold out America, because Trent Lott knew that a new freshman Congress was coming in and he didn't want them to have to deal with this investigation. So they made the Senate hearing go bye-bye, even though they knew Bill Clinton broke the law. So it's really terrible. And, you know, Trump has never broken the law. There's no proof that he's ever broken the law, anything to that extent. And look where that went. And they almost kicked him out. So,
right.
You know, it's interesting, but I think the Hunter Biden issue is a real mess.
It is. I'm Attorney Phil Jusino here with David Zere. You're listening to Phil Jusino Drive at 5 on 103.9 FM, LA News Radio. I got to read a couple of commercials to pay the bills. Let's have a little Italian traveling music. Panico's Community Market. For over 40 years, Panico's Community Market on Terry Road in Smithtown has been serving some of the best quality meats, cheeses, and other great foods. Panico's offers full catering menus, recipes, cooking videos, barbecue, seasonal menus, and much more. Visit their website to see all of their delicious options. Ray Pearson of Coldwell Banker has been in the real estate business for over 20 years. Ray has cultivated a style of business that is based on high trust and low stress. Let Ray guide you through the buying and or selling process step by step with professionalism and expertise that is often hard to find. Give Ray a call at 631-626-2140. That's 626-2140. And we're going to read one more. If you have a 401k, or a plan administrator, and you want the best results possible, give Federated Securities a call. They've been around since 1970 here on Long Island. Give them 15 minutes, and you might just save 15%. Time well spent. Give them a call. 431-421-4499. That's 631-421-4499. I wanted to talk briefly about the black vote, which I've been hearing a lot about lately. And remember, you know, obviously, you know who I'm talking about, Leo Tyrell.
He's great.
Civil rights attorney. I remember when I used to watch him when he was to the left. Mm-hmm. I used to yell at the TV, and I'm like, why is this guy coming on? And then the transformation, I've never seen anything like it.
Well, that's what this whole BLM thing is about, because Trump was making so much headway with the black community up until March, you know, that they're doing anything they can to take away from that. I spend a lot of time with black leaders across the country. You know, I've interviewed like Candace Owens and
she's great.
Other people. But on my show, I have Vince Everett Ellison on. Vince Everett Ellison is a black guy from the South. He spent 5 years in jail when he was younger. He grew up in a Christian family as a singer in the Baptist church. And he's really upset because he feels the Democrats exploit them for their vote. And he wrote a book called The Iron Triangle, which means the Democratic clergy with the Democratic civic associations and then the DNC, the Democratic Party, have a triangular thumb on the black vote, and they expect it for the last 100 years. There's a big walkaway. It's huge. I just had another guy named Pete Sherrill. He was a Democrat for 40 years on my show. He wrote a book, Living in Trump's America, Being Black. He was great. And, you know, there's so many people like that who have come out. I think Trump gets 12 to 15% of the black vote.
I said about 15%, yeah.
He got 8 last time. If he gets 12, 13% of the black vote and he got 29% of the Latino vote and this winds up to be 35% in this election, he's got the election in the bag. Black men are moving towards Trump more than black women.
Right.
It's an interesting dynamic. But I think they see the truth. They're tired of being told, you know, how to vote. And they look at
you ain't black. Remember that saying? Remember
yeah. Yeah. And you look at every single major city in America and they're all run by Democrats and they also have the highest crime rates. And the black community, you know, there's 9,000 black on black murders every year. There's 85% of racial crime is black on white. 550,000 felonies are committed by blacks against white people every year. 70% of the fathers are not in the homes. And it goes to the same in like white Appalachia. It's not just the black problem right. and all that. But, you know, it's just the fact that they're not doing anything to fix the problems, the Democrats in these. They just take the vote for granted, right? Yeah.
Dave, we're going to be taking a break shortly. You're going to come back the second half of the show. We have coming up, we're going to have Annie Dillon call in from El Dorado Hills Republican Women's Federated, which is an organization that's promoting President Trump in California. She tells me that they believe that they might be able to turn California red. I'm not sure about that. I'd love to see it. That would be great. I'd like to see New York turn red, but I'm not so sure about that. Stick around. You're listening to Phil Jusino and David Zere. Phil Jusino Drive at 5 here on 103.9 FM, LI News Radio. Attorney Phil Jusino, and you are back with Phil Jusino Drive at 5 every Monday at 5 p.m. here on 103.9 FM, LI News Radio. I have David Zere in the studio with me. You've been listening to. He's with Breaking Point on Real America's Voice News. We have a call-in guest we're going to patch in. Her name is Annie Dillon. She's with the El Dorado Hills Republican Women's Federated in Northern California. Annie, are you on?
Hi, how are you?
Good, good. Welcome aboard. Annie, we spoke last night, and you told me that you would love to see California go red, and you were somewhat optimistic.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Why are you optimistic mm-hmm. about California going? And I hope it happens. I'm a little, what's the word I'm looking for? I'd be shocked, but tell me why.
Mm-hmm. I'll tell you, the conservative movement going on here in California, it's palpable. We are fired up for Trump, and people here love him. You know, we're focusing on these big cities. You know, you guys hear a lot about Sacramento or San Francisco and Los Angeles, but really, California is a big state, and there's a lot of people here who really are conservative, and we want to see the California go in a good direction, get it turned around.
Right, but do you think, like I was explaining to you, there are 62 counties in New York State. Donald Trump mm-hmm. won 45 of them. It still wasn't enough because the blue city centers here in New York, mm-hmm. New York City, Rochester, you know, you name the big cities, they carry the day. Doesn't that happen in California, L.A.? Look at San Francisco. That's not going red mm-hmm. in a million years.
No, no.
But do you think you have numbers from other... You were telling me about somebody you knew, I don't know if she was Vietnamese, that might be voting for President Trump?
Yes, I have a friend who's from Vietnam. She's lived here 26 years. She said, I have never voted, ever, ever. And no one in my family or my community ever votes. But this year, we will all be voting for Trump because we are small business owners. We are passionate about seeing him win for 4 more years.
Right. And you've had rallies. Do you run those rallies? Or are you part of those rallies?
Well, we go. We go to the rallies. They're so fun. They are boat rallies that are taking place on the Sacramento River. Thousands of boats show up. Mm-hmm. They are covered in Trump flags, families on the boats. They're driving up and down, having a great time. Every weekend, there's different road rallies that are popping up all over the state, like from way up north, like Lake Shasta, all the mm-hmm. way down to Beverly Hills and Newport Beach. And these road rallies are miles long. People are jumping out of their cars to wave and cheer and
We have them here. What about the black and Hispanic vote? And the Hispanic vote is very big in California. What have you heard about that?
Mm-hmm. Well, at the rallies, I'll tell you what, they're showing up. At the rallies, we went to a big one in Minden, which is right on the border of California and Nevada. Lots of black Hispanic, white, Asian, Indian, everybody, old, young. There was a large LGBT presence there. It was just so fun to see everybody. And everyone's so nice. And they just want to cheer on the president. They want good for our country. It's so exciting to see this diverse group of people all come together.
And you think it'll be a big red wave? You think, like in New York here,
I would love to see that.
A lot of Republicans say we're going to vote on November 3rd.
Mm-hmm.
You seeing that?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Where people are expressing that desire not to vote early, not to send in a ballot, a mail-in ballot.
Yeah. And I think that this is part of what we're doing with our Republican women's group is educating ourselves and our friends, the people in our community, on why it's so important to vote. Mm-hmm. Even if it's just working on the local props, things like that, we need to have people get out and vote. And a lot of times, and we're telling people this too, they think, well, California is just kind of automatically be blue, so I don't even think I'll vote. But if all those people who said that went out and vote, our chances are going to get closer to turning it red.
That's true. Now, I have David Zere with me. He's been part of a lot of these rallies. You have any questions for our California friend?
Well, we know a lot of the rallies are organic, and there's nothing going on for Biden. You know, Trump's got about 450,000 people to his Trump rally since he went back on the road, and Biden got about 800. So when do you see any rallies for Biden in California?
No, I haven't seen any. I see a few yard signs around, but that's about it.
Wow.
I haven't seen anything for Biden.
Yeah, in Florida the other day, last week, they had 50 golf carts come out at Pembroke Pines for Biden while 30,000 Cubans were out in their trucks and cars honking for Trump all day down the road.
That's interesting. So you're really confident that that you guys could do it in California, huh?
Oh, I hope so. I hope so. That's what we're pushing for it.
Well, you know what it is? You got to do everything you can. And I always say it's not rocket science. You just have to have more votes than the other side. Now, it's not easy from New York. It's not easy from California. We know that. It's not Florida. It's not Pennsylvania. But listen, I keep fighting. You got to fight the good fight every day. Keep going. You got 7 days in a wake up, as I say, like they say in the military, 7 days in a wake up. You keep going strong. And hopefully you and I can speak on the 4th or 5th of November be happy that whether he wins New York or not, you know what? He's got to win the election. That's the main thing. But I really want to thank you for taking this call and being part of the show tonight. Thank you.
Thank you. You guys have a good day.
Take care. Dave, what have you been seeing here with the rallies? The other day I was on exit. I was going to the city and I got on at 62. I was going about 60 miles an hour. Cars on the other side were part of that Trump rally. This is a couple of weeks ago. I went to exit 50 and it was still going. I'd never seen anything like it before.
Yeah, I've been part of many of the rallies and planning some of them. And my friends in the Long Island Loud Majority, the Setauket Patriots, the Huntington Northport Patriots, we've gotten about 50,000 cars on the road in the past 7 or 8 weeks.
That's incredible.
It's an incredible thing. And, you know, yesterday in Eisenhower Park, there were many thousands, close to 10,000 in attendance. Bernard McGurk from WABC Radio hosted it. I was one of the speakers yesterday. It was a truly phenomenal day. And Trump tweeted about it. And then he spoke about it again today in Pennsylvania and then yesterday in New Hampshire. These rallies are amazing and they're organic. These are not like, you know, I work for the highway department and they told me to go hang some signs for a candidate. This is, you know, for the candidate who runs the township they're in.
Sure.
You know, there's like an army of soldiers, you know. But that's not what this is. This is a very, very grassroots campaign. You know, the GOP isn't exactly great at grassroots campaigning. The Democrats always have the social media, the college students, Trump. You know, Obama had massive turnouts in the colleges and stuff. But there's a sea change, and that has changed. People are fed up. They don't want to be locked in their house. They want to run their business. They're dying. They're not able to, you know, carry this on their backs anymore. And I think we're in for a big surprise. Maybe we can shift to that later. But
sure.
The rallies, they're every day at all the train stations. And then on the weekends, there's big ones with 3, 4, 5. We had Truckers for Trump right here in Ronkonkoma about 3 weeks ago. There were 5,000 trucks and cars. And they went all the way to the Queens border and came back. But more importantly, I participated in Operation Flag Drop, where we dropped a Keep America Great, Blue Lives Matter banner over the BLM mural outside of Trump Tower.
Oh, you did, huh?
And we got massive views on social media, and the Trump, and Trump tweeted it and everything, and the kids did too, you know, Eric and Don Jr. But my mother participated in one 2 weeks ago, and she posted it on Facebook. She got 2.2 million views so far. You know, people are really fired up about this stuff. And yesterday, 3 days ago, there was another rally, a flag drop in the city that Long Islanders ran, the Long Island Loud Majorities, the Talk of Patriots, and these other groups. And 33 Antifa were arrested by the cops at the thing. They're throwing stuff at us. They're fighting us. There was a woman yesterday at our rally that was bruised up and down her body who came after being beaten up in the city at a Trump rally by the left. And came out and still spoke at a rally. And all the violence is from the left. You never see violence from the right in America. It's very rare. It's 99 to 1. There's been 800 attacks on Trump supporters over the last 3 years that are recorded. My co-host's head was broken open in California with a pipe by Antifa. So, you know, we're tired of being told that we're bad for being good. And they flip the narrative. On BLM's website, they want to break down the nuclear family. Everybody's not allowed to be a normal person anymore. You have to have some problem, some emotional problem. You're sensitive. You need a safe space. There's no rugged individualism that made this country great. And I think that's what people are yearning. Reagan brought it back after Carter. Trump brought it back. Mm-hmm. And I think he wins in a landslide.
Yeah, you know what was sad? The other day, the Jews in the city were having a rally, in a sense. Yeah.
That was part of
rocks were thrown
yesterday
at them.
Yeah, it was terrible. It was terrible. They're very violent. And but it's depravity. It's depravity. You know, these people do this for a living. They're all still getting unemployment checks. And, you know, one third of Long Island out of the workforce works for the government in some level. And everybody's home getting paid. You know, the nurses, the teachers, and civil service, and all the other branches of government. You know, the deli owners, you know, the Fireside Deli's out after 40 years in business. The Bonwood Inn's gone.
Wow.
Dangerfield's Comedy Club, out of business. Ellen Stardust Diner, out of business.
Yeah, I know some comedians, and it's horrible. They can't work.
The Parisian restaurant's been there since 1880 in the city, gone. La Bernardin, probably the best restaurant in the world, out, gone. So, you know, these rallies are about more than just supporting Donald Trump. People are tired of being told they need to wear a mask when they're healthy. 70% of people who get COVID get it, who've gotten COVID, wear their mask all the time.
Right.
And 70% of people who get COVID get it sitting inside their house or in a nursing home. So people are tired.
Yeah, they are. Let me read a couple of commercials. State Farm, switching is easy. We do it all the time. We switch on the lights. We switch TV channels. We switch partners while square dancing sometimes. But you know what's a good switch? When you switch and save with State Farm. In fact, State Farm agent Randy Pelosi, good guy, I know him well, right here in Stony Brook, can switch you over so you can start saving money today. Randy and his team make it easy to switch and save fast. Give Randy a call, 631-751-6800. That's 631-751-6800 when you want the real deal. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. One more, Edge USA, with over 20 years' experience. Edge USA serves all 5 boroughs and can fill all your transportation needs, warehousing, and logistical needs as well. Call them at 631-682-2155. That's 631-682-2155. Or visit their website, edgeusainc.net, for a quote and more information. Dave, during the break, we were talking about Hunter Biden, and you said some more information has come out.
Yeah, there's a new story.
And since you're not going to hear it on other stations, tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, breaking news.
Right. Breaking news.
Hunter Biden, was accused of inappropriate sexual activity with a family member. And it's been covered up. And that story's coming out in the news and breaking in the news. So I don't know how many media outlets will pay attention to that. But worse than that, you know, they think there's activity with underage girls. And people say, what's the difference? You know, it's just the son of the vice president. Right. He was on Air Force One, Air Force Two with Joe Biden for many, many years. And there's no way, like, if Joe Biden went for security clearance right now in the United States government, he couldn't get it unless he gets elected to be president. I think he's compromised all day long. But in many countries, not just in China and the Ukraine, like places like Kazakhstan and Russia. We know he received money from Russia.
Right. And when he said, I didn't receive money directly, it doesn't matter because his son's receiving the money directly and getting it to the rest of the family.
Yeah, and the son's insinuated that in text messages.
Right, he's the big guy.
And he gets a portion of the proceeds. He said something to his sister where, you know, unlike you, you know, dad won't take half your money that you bring in. So obviously there's some type of financial beneficial relationship, but it's like, you know, how do you go into office and make $200,000 to $400,000 per year and all of a sudden you're worth like tens of millions of dollars?
What did Harry Truman say? If you become rich being a politician, you're a crook. You know, it's one thing to write books into all this. But look at Obama. He came into office. He didn't have much.
But it's not like Biden's been in the private sector for 40 years.
No, he hasn't.
20 years after a presidency.
Right. Trump was a businessman. That's where he made his money.
Yeah, and we don't have a problem with anybody making money. And I don't have a problem with anything. I got to tell you the difference in between the kids of the president. I've gotten to know Don Jr. and Eric from the campaign trail pretty closely, you know. I don't go fishing with them, but I see them all over the place, and they've been really gracious, and I sponsored their book launches in New York and D.C., and I got to tell you, they are a class act, and for billionaires' kids, like Don Jr. told me in an interview that, you know, he grew up with a golden toilet bowl in the penthouse at Trump Tower, but he spent the summers in Czechoslovakia, where their grandparents fought communism for 50 years, and I was in Russia in 2016 under the communist system, and there was no food on the shelves, so I can relate. So their grandfather, with Ivanka, Erica, and Don Jr. growing up in Czechoslovakia for their summers, they like beat it into them. The grandparents beat it into them to be decent people and taught them how to hunt. And the grandfather waited 8 hours a day online for an orange. You know, Don Jr. told me stories, and that they went when they would be fishing outside of Mar-a-Lago behind them, which is their residence in Florida.
Right.
There was 56 bathrooms in there, and the grandfather's like, "You see that? That means nothing." And they were really grounded. And the other thing I love about it is that Donald Trump made them work, and they can operate the cranes and the bulldozers on the job sites.
Sure.
And they were scaling fish on the docks in Atlantic City when they were teenagers. They weren't traveling around the world. So I got to say, there's a big difference between the families. Even like Chelsea Clinton, who in my opinion is, you know, just a little brat.
How much did she get for that?
Great people. $900,000.
Oh, my God.
So, you know, again, I have no problem with anybody making money. But Biden is not a private sector guy, and
he never was.
Doesn't know anything about business or building a business.
Right. In the time we have left, you've been to some of those Trump rallies where Trump gives a speech.
Yes.
Okay. What I marvel at is the energy of that man at 74 years old. I don't care. A 25-year-old might not have that kind of energy. Three rallies a day. He's hopping in a plane, flying to another location. He never looks tired.
Well, he's never had a drink or a cigarette in his life, so it's probably part of his stamina. I got to tell you, I've covered about 17 Trump rallies around the country. You know, I fly in the morning or the night before. We get ready. We do like a pre-show taping. Like we have a show called The Great American Diner Road Trip, like Fox and Friends does, and then we do a pre-rally show. And so my point is that, you know, we're on our feet for the whole day and everything. We're wiped out. We are wiped out. Like, we can't even move at the end of the night. And Trump gets off, like, the night after his nomination speech, he was tweeting until 2 in the morning the night of his acceptance speech.
That's amazing.
He shows up in New Hampshire, you know, fit as a fiddle, ready to go. And, like, my director of programming, Dr. Gina Loudon, texted me. She's like, "I don't know where the hell this guy gets his energy." You know, she was with him the night before. It's a phenomenon. And I don't think anybody, it's not really just about his health. Nobody works harder than him. You know, Biden was absent for 6 of the last 7 days before the last debate because they had to flip his schedule around.
Yeah, Sunday to Thursday, he went underground. You didn't know where he was.
They reversed his sleep schedule so he can stay awake for the debate.
That's amazing. Let me just read two quick more commercials. The proposed Long Island Career Charter School, a not-for-profit educational institution that will serve students in grades 6 through 12 in Wyandanch in the fall of 2022, has a strong mission to cultivate the potential in its students. The Long Island Career Charter Schools is actively pre-enrolling Suffolk County students who will be of middle age and high school age in the fall of 2022. Residents outside of Wyandanch can apply. Visit liccs.net to sign up or to learn more about the school. And lastly, Americans for Legal Reform. If you had the misfortune of getting a raw deal in the judicial system, your divorce or family court matter, or just want to get more involved in the system, they're all out of order. Join Americans for Legal Reform. Americans for Legal Reform seek to protect the rights of Americans who deserve to be treated fairly by judges and the system without prejudice. AFLR meets once a week. I've spoken at their meetings. You can sign up for their mailing list at AmericansForTheNumeralLegalReform.com or like the Facebook page under the same name. Good organization. If you want to get involved, give them a buzz or just go to their website, Americans for Legal Reform. In the last minute and 30, what do you think, Dave, that the president, the guy's nonstop. If he's not successful, I'll be shocked. And it's not because he didn't try. You know, when Biden loses, they're going to look at that, just like they did. Remember Dukakis took a vacation right after he won the primary? What does President Trump have to do, and we only got about a minute or so left, have to do in the waning days of this election?
Well, I think both sides are going to be slinging mud really hard. The Biden stuff is, I think, going to sink. The Hunter Biden stuff will sink Joe Biden. I think that Trump did three rallies today alone in Pennsylvania.
Any more tonight?
He's a machine, probably. And we can't even keep up with it at Real America's Voice. And we dedicated a whole army of people to covering the president. You know, I think he's going to go strong all week. I think there's going to be some really bad things that are untrue coming up about the president by the end of the week. But I don't think it's going to stick. I think there might be games at the stock market. There might be other things. But I think there's a premature sell-off going on at the hedge that Biden could get in, you know, and people are worried and they're taking their money out.
That could be.
I think Trump wins.
I do, too. I called it in 16. You may have, too.
Yep.
I called it in 16.
I did.
People thought I was crazy. You know what? That's what I felt. I think he's going to win. Independence, I always say momentum and enthusiasm. And there's only one candidate that right now has momentum and enthusiasm. Have a good night, guys. Thank you.